This is the heart of this cloistered Trappist nun community, gathering for worship and prayer 7 times a day, starting at 3:15 in the morning. And this is the Cheese Barn, where the 12 sisters at Our Lady of the Angels make close to 20,000 pounds of Gouda every year. Most of their $250,000 business is mail order, although some local shops drive out monthly for the cheese their customers crave.
The flavor's great. It's on the mild end in terms of, you know, intensity, but it's delicious and you know, really versatile. You can use it for cooking, or you can just nosh it with salami and olives and bread.
When they started, the nuns knew nothing about how to make cheese. Today, they literally cannot keep up with the demand from food connoisseurs around the country.
It sort of sells itself. People get it as a gift. And they call and they say, could I order some of this cheese?
Sister Barbara is one of the original 6 who was sent by a large monastery in Massachusetts to start anew on this gorgeous piece of land near Charlottesville, Virginia. The goal, followed the centuries-old rules of St. Benedict by building a life based on prayer and engage in manual labor to support themselves. Happily for the sisters, the property they bought already featured a cheese-making facility.
We were so naive, we thought it'd be so simple. You have some of this equipment here, and you just get some milk and a few lessons and just make some cheese.
But the sisters persevered, and they got it right, really right. They allot 30-some days a year to make the Gouda, and everyone pitches in. Sister Maria is the designated cheese cook. She must manipulate some 6,000 pounds of pasteurized milk with a little culture and rennet into several hundred wheels of cheese. It looks easy, but like any good recipe, it's all about precision. Getting the correct temperature, cutting the curds at just the right moment, heating them, then draining the whey, and finally, pressing the cheese. Over the years, the sisters have not only perfected their technique, they have never bungled a batch. That's almost unheard of. The sisters say prayer is a big part of their work, from making the cheese to sending it out.
While I'm doing it, I'm really praying for the people who are gonna eat that cheese. I mean, I know every family, every person have problems.
For every 5 cheese orders that come in the mail, at least one, maybe out of every 4, one will have a request for prayers.
Prayer is also the reason the nuns say they won't grow their business.
People will come in and say, well, you sold out last year, so you're going to make more next year, aren't you?
What is happening here? A seeking after the Lord that is visibly discernible.
It's fun to see the nuns, and they're so, you know, kind and calm and mellow. It sort of slows you down a little bit.
When they're not in the chapel or making the cheese, the nuns do admit to eating it, often. And there is a preferred method.
You toast a piece of bread so that the bread is kind of crispy. And then you put a couple thin slices of cheese on, put it in the microwave for 25 seconds.
Flash forward to 2020, and the sisters say the pandemic has made them even more conscious of the need to pray. They're especially mindful of healthcare workers and those who have lost a loved one. A new puppy, Skippy, has added joy to their lives, but otherwise, their days continue as they always have, full of prayer and ministry opportunities in simple 2-pound wheels of cheese. Heather Sells, CBN News.